Now, more from the neighborhood. KCRA3's Danielle is live with some neighbors there who are frustrated. They're still locked out, and they still, on Friday night, can't get back into their homes. Can you imagine that, Danielle?
You know, talking to a lot of these people, they say at this point their cell phones are dying, their laptops are dying, they can't get in to get new clothes. But what they're really worried about is a lot of people inside these apartments have their pets locked up inside. We even talked to some people who are separated from their families. Now, earlier today, we were contacted by a KCRA 3 insider via flip camera. He has been locked inside this barricaded area since Wednesday when this whole standoff began. Actually, yesterday, his family had to coordinate with officers just to get him his prescription medication. And they've been worried about him and how he's doing with everything that's been going on inside this apartment. We did speak to his son earlier tonight. Here's what he had to say about the whole process.
It's kind of like, you know, you feel like you're kind of a nomad. You know, the batteries on your smartphone goes dead and you're like, okay, now I don't have access to my bank accounts. I don't have my phone numbers to my friends and stuff like that. Then the laptop goes dead. And then, you know, now you're just kind of cut off, kind of wandering around. Was it inconvenient? Yeah. Was it kind of expensive? Yeah.
A lot of people did rush to the scene when the standoff ended, hoping to get inside. They were turned away until tomorrow, and officers are still saying that is the earliest that people will be allowed back in. On a side note, that is just in time for Owen's birthday. He's turning 62 tomorrow. Now, coming up tonight at 11, we did speak to the on-site manager of this apartment complex who has essentially been living in her van parked outside in order to help officers and find out how she's been doing, not being able to get inside to her stuff. Reporting live in Sacramento, Danielle Lee, KCRA 3 reports.
Well, Danielle, it's easy to understand why the law enforcement there wants to process the scene where the standoff happened and then, of course, where they were able to rescue the baby. But as for the people who live around, I mean, what are police saying is the reason that people just can't come back to their homes to get some sleep and to kind of get their lives back together?
You know, officers are still investigating. They're still processing the scene, finalizing everything that's led up to the end of this standoff. And because of that, they don't want people going in and out, possibly tampering some of that evidence because, again, the suspect was killed in the end of the standoff.
Danielle, one quick question you may or may not know about the Arden Way closure. Are they going to be opening Arden Way? Is Arden Way reopened?
You know, I was just on Arden Way about 15 minutes ago, and it had not been reopened. They are directing people to go to Alta Arden still at this point. However, I don't know at what time they will be reopening that street.
All right. Thanks, Danielle.